Hi Beatle people, welcome back to A Beautiful Life. So today is the day, it is Paul Day. I'll be seeing Paul at Syracuse tonight, so this will be a vlog of that, obviously. I just got this shirt from the Got Back Tour merchandise section of his website, and I have my Paul necklace on and my I Love Paul pin, so I am ready to go. I don't want to spend too much time talking at the beginning of this video, I just want to get to the vlog, I'm sure you do as well. So I'll save the talking for the end, and let's go.
Right, this love of mine. made a band and did okay for themselves. But you know, in the beginning, when we first started out in Liverpool, we were just a gigging band. And yeah, it wasn't easy to get work. So we worked it out that if we had a demo record, then we might be able to play that to people. We might get a few gigs. So. the broken-hearted people living in the world. So live and let die.
Thank you.
Syracuse rules. See you next time.
All right, so that was the concert portion of this video. I hope you enjoyed watching that. So this is going to be kind of just the talking part of the video now. So I know some of my concert clips were a little short. I figured there's already so many clips from this tour on YouTube that it wasn't really needed for me to film everything. Plus, I didn't want to be too worried about what was going on with my phone, you know, what I was filming. I wanted to just be able to focus on what was in front of me, obviously. So as you can imagine, one of the most exciting parts of everything was when we saw Paul arrive at the stadium. I never got a chance to do that before, so that was so exciting. You could see in the video everyone was screaming. It was so cool. He must have been like, I don't know, like 10 feet away or something. We even tried singing a little bit of Hey Jude as he was pulling up, and then everyone just started yelling. It was so cool. So I wanted to talk a little bit about soundcheck as well. So videos weren't allowed in soundcheck, so I only got a couple pictures, but for soundcheck you stand about, I'd say, halfway back in the venue, so he's not super close to take good pictures anyway. Plus I knew I'd be getting plenty of stuff during the show, but I will put the soundcheck set list on the screen here so you can see that. I was so excited that he played Jet, because that is one of my big favorites, and he played Mrs. Vanderbilt, which is another one I love, and I was, for the whole ending part, I was jumping up and down. It was really fun. So the soundcheck itself it was my third time doing soundcheck, by the way. It is really cool because you get to kind of see them prepare for the show, you get to be part of that, so it you know, extends the experience, and then after the soundcheck, you have a dinner. I think the food for that varies by venue, because I saw a completely different menu for that at another venue, but we had like pasta and salad and vegetables, and there was a big dessert table and, you know, beverages there as well. So that was cool, and it was another way to kind of make it a very full experience, because between the sound check and the dinner and, you know, getting there early and everything, it really adds like an extra few hours to the whole experience. So we had a very kind of full day. So the show itself was awesome, as you can imagine. I really like the Hot City horns. I think they're a great addition. I hadn't seen them before, and they're really fun. They bring good energy, and they dance a lot, actually, like together, like coordinated dancing. I actually didn't record Lady Madonna, I think, because I had just heard that at soundcheck, so I didn't film it, but they were really like grooving during that. And Live and Let Die gets better every time, I think, with the pyrotechnics. There was like fireworks shooting up the Jumbotron screen. There was stuff popping in the air, like it was just everywhere. It was so cool. And I wanted to make sure I got a clip of Paul walking on stage, because I realized in all the times that I saw him, I never got a clip of that. Oh, and by the way, I have my new Got Back tour poster behind me there. So yes, overall it was an amazing show, and I'm so happy that I got to see Paul again. Prior to that show, I hadn't seen him in almost 5 years, so I'm very glad that I was able to see him again, and that he came around here on this tour. And so as I'm filming this, it's actually like 5 days since the concert. I didn't want to film right after because I'm usually pretty sad the day after, but the good news is I see Ringo in just 3 days, so that'll be another great show. That's in Easton, Pennsylvania, that I'm seeing him. So I actually don't think that venue allows video recording, so I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to put together a video of that. Maybe I'll be able to take some pictures. So yeah, I think that's everything I wanted to talk about. I hope I didn't miss anything. I think I'm going to wrap the video up here. So I know it's a pretty long video. So I want to say thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed watching, and I'll leave my social media linked in the description. I actually posted some video clips on Instagram that I didn't include in this video, so you could see those if you want. But again, thank you for watching, and as always, have a beautiful day, everybody. Bye-bye.